What is up, guys? You got Not the Worst here, bringing another Black Desert Online video. Before we get into that, I did want to tell you guys about MMOTimer.com. It is a boss tracking website that'll tell you, as you can see, what bosses are spawning when, what time, and you can select any server that you are on. It works for all servers there, so you can see who comes up, how much longer you got until then. So pretty handy tool. If you haven't used it before, be sure to check it out. So today we're taking a look at, I guess, the next step or gear progression. What's been going on with my next steps in BDO. So lately I have been doing some, I guess, enhancement gambling. For those of you that caught the live streams, lately I've been doing a lot of accessory enhancing, which has been going fairly well. So when this sells here shortly, we'll be a little over 8 billion in funds, with about 5 billion of that being from a couple of enhancing sessions. Basically what I do is just slam some reblath gear up until 18 stacks for a pry, buy whatever I feel like enhancing at that time for pry, and then I start the duos pretty low, around 26 or so, and then I've been doing the tries around 34, or right about that point. Something else alongside that, of course, the weekend enhancing streams I've been doing for pen bags attempts, although it has not been going well the last couple of times we tried. So sometimes when I'm doing some attempts there, I end up with a whole bunch of extra fail stacks, so I'll actually just use some of those for accessories and end up making a little bit of profit. It's actually been all profitable every time I've tried this, which is about 4 streams worth doing it, except for one of them. I ended up making the profit back a little bit later during that stream, but I was down pretty bad the one time I was doing a bunch of tongue grad items, just because they cost about triple what the other accessories cost. So yeah, string of bad luck on specifically duo accessories there definitely had an impact on how profitable it was. So that being the case, between that and I'm just kind of goofing around at Kadri here doing whatever, finish the Star's End video. I do like grinding there in general, but I'm kind of thinking about what the next move for 20-hour grind is going to be. I know Miramax's on the table. Also, Gaha's I've never done a 20-hour grind on, so we kind of like overlooked that one. I know that's super, super popular for newer players, so maybe I go back and get that out of the way. But as far as gear goes and then what I'm doing, content-wise, I really like doing the accessory enhancing. I understand that I'm just on a string of pretty darn good luck with tries and tets. At one point I had I made 4 try accessories in a single sitting, 1 Ruins Ring and 3 Voltara belts, and then was thinking about, do I sell those or try and swing one of them for tets? Since I had Bazzies and Crescent Rings, it would actually be an upgrade with the HP. So I ended up swinging all 4 on tet, and 3 of them blew up. The Voltara actually went tet, so I got to swap out my Bazzy belt for a Voltara belt, got a little upgrade there, so that's not bad. I wouldn't be completely against doing that with Ruin Rings if I found myself in a position similar to that again. The next thing I've been kind of thinking about, aside from that, is if we take a look at Distortion earrings right now, these are coming down in price at try pretty significantly. So I could pretty much just buy a try outright right now, which would obviously be the equivalent AP to a Tet Tungrad earring, and I have Capotia or Capotia and a Tungrad earring equipped, so I could pick up an extra 2 AP right out of the gate there, and I do have enough Caphras already just sitting and chilling, without even combining a bunch of dust I have around on different characters. I could actually just go ahead and level 3 Caphras my Beg's Gloves, so that I would maintain my 316 DP with Kudum. This wouldn't do anything really to my Awakening, since it would just put me at 271, and that increase, which isn't a new bracket, till 2 more AP at 273, but it would get my pre-awakening to 269 bracket with Kudum equipped, which would be pretty sexy, as well as pushing my Nuver AP to 281 main hand as well bracket without hurting the DP, provided that I spend the Caphras. So I'm not sure that I want to do this, and I want to know what you guys think. Let me know in the comments what you're out to go. I'm not in a rush to do anything anyhow. I could just keep stacking money and figure something else out, maybe go for the Tungrads outright, or even try just enhancing my own try distortion earrings. The only thing is that what I find interesting is the base price ones. These came down to about 319, I think, was the cheapest I saw today, and it's kind of been that way. You can see the sales, yeah, 319 it was. The sales coming out for these, they throughout the day they seem to like trickle on down a little ways, and then at the end of the day then you'll see this kind of effect where everything's back up to max price where it really should be. So I'm not so sure if paying at max price for these makes sense when the try These have been sitting for 2 days at 6.8. At one point today, there were 8 of them listed, so there are people purchasing them, which is why the price isn't decreasing from here, because we haven't hit the bottom price. You can see when they were first out, they had to, of course, rise in price over time. But that is an option. Buying this thing, which I could do immediately, does indeed give me 2 AP gain right away. But more importantly than just the 2 AP gain, that also means we can just straight up pull the Tungrat Earring out and swing for Tet on it. So there's a potential that we get a 4 AP gain out of that, which that is actually a very, very big deal, because that's going to push a new bracket for both the main hand and awakening hand in each. So then we're talking about some real increase from there. I'm not against maybe sitting down and doing a weekend enhancing session on the Tri-Distortion Earrings and just kind of keeping the accessory enhancing going like we have been, hopefully continuing to make profit off of that. Alternatively, I have probably, if I combine the dust that I have on my life skilling character, I'm sure I need like 602, and I could Kafris my main hand one more level, so it would boost it up 1 AP. That would still be 1 AP short of another bracket at 268, since my Dandy is level 1 as well, so it has 1 AP. Otherwise these would be equal if this wasn't already pushed up 1, but that gets me the next bracket. So I'm kind of in between with what to do there. Other content development wise, this bad boy right here, you can see how pretty my boy Skittles is looking right here. We picked him up on stream a little while ago during an enhancing session. I think we made a quick billion real fast, and then decided to, since I was still using a T7 and trying to train up a T8 courser, we decided to just go ahead and buy a T8 courser, level up some of the skills on stream, which we did. That was kind of fun, and we've been doing, along with the Saturday night enhancing streams, we're kicking those off now with a couple of dream attempts. So each Saturday, I'm going to be doing 2 dream horse attempts. I want to get unicorn, but realistically, I'm just going to grab whatever materials I have already available or what's readily available on the market beforehand, and just make sure I get the crons ready if I don't get them out of my rift bosses, which I seem to get them just fine out of rift bosses, so there's that as well. So we've been doing dream horse, then we kind of run for Penbeg's attempt, sort of, and then do some accessory enhancing for whatever. But I'm kind of just want to hear from what you guys. What do you guys want to see us go for? What would next step be? Keep in mind, I'm more focused on what's enjoyable content for everybody, what you guys want to see happen, more so than like what's the most efficient way to progress from here. Once that belt sells, I mean, I wouldn't be too far off from actually being able to just buy a Tet Tungrad earring. So then we wouldn't even have to worry about the DP thing. Granted, DP loss isn't a huge deal, but I do like being right in that 316 bracket with my Kudamon. It does have some effect that I enjoy during PvE for sure, but I'm not completely married to it, and I can always make it back in other Kafris levels, or you know, going some other route. So not against just not doing that at all. I would go either way, but I just want to know what you guys think. You would like to see us do, especially if you are a regular to some of the live streams, so that way you guys are seeing the content live and kind of get a feel for what's the most fun to do when you guys are watching the stream. So that's where I'm sitting at. That's what I'm thinking at. Doing a little bit of Kadri just some off time here, just because you get insane black stones, which really, really helps when we're doing the Reblath building fail stacks, since most of the duo accessories, if we're not doing a pen begs alongside it, I typically have just been using Reblath gear to make the 30 plus stacks as well, which hasn't really been too difficult. It's been honestly pretty easy. I know a lot of you guys that are a lot of the regulars to live stream have seen it. We made some 40 stacks and things like that too. So anyways, that is where I'm at. That's what I'm thinking about. Let me know what you guys think about in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you guys, what your perspective on it, or is there something I'm missing? Is there something else that I could be doing progress-wise that I'm not even seeing that might be a good use of it? Should I just stack up the money and figure it out later on, or what's the next move from here? I can tell you what I'm not interested to do, because some people have mentioned it. I really have zero interest in going for Penuver right now. Reason for that is it's like a 2 AP gain and like, I don't know, 1 DP or something. The gain is really, really minimal. And to me, getting a pen begs that accuracy bonus and the extra 5 DP is far more appealing to me than 2 AP gain off of an offhand that I barely ever use, since I'm always PvEing for the grind videos and whatnot. So that one's pretty much off the table. If you were thinking of recommending that, I'm not super interested in going. Eventually I will. Of course we'll go for pen at some point in it, but that's not my next for fun pen enhancing on the weekends. It's definitely gonna be begs for now, and I already have a backup begs that we're using to do it with anyways, so it's not like it's been very painful. So with that said, that's going to be it for this video. Be sure to like it if you did enjoy it. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe so you get notifications when videos go live. We've always got patch note recaps coming out. We got guides. If you haven't seen it, our 20-hour grind series, the Silver Breakdowns, those are pretty cool, where I go into detail of different grinding zones for 20 hours, pull up a spreadsheet, and give you a breakdown of what type of loot you're seeing in specific zones. So those are pretty neat if you want to check that out. There's a playlist, actually, if you check out my channel, and it'll list all of the 20-hour grind videos for you there if you want to see that. And other than that, this is just one of our standard gear progression videos that we put out every once or 2 weeks, depending on what's been going on lately. So with that said, that is going to be it for this video. Before I go, I do want to mention, if you do want to catch any of the live streams I just talked about, especially the Saturday night Dream Horse and enhancing streams, which are a whole lot of fun, make sure you head on over to the Twitch page. There's a link in the description below you can click on and just drop a follow over there so you get a notification whenever we go live. That way you can come check out the stream and hang out with us and maybe catch some cool enhancements and hopefully a Dream Horse coming up not too soon. With that said, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you, everybody, for watching, and I will see you next time.